Hi everyone, my name is Francesco Fantechi, and today I want to be talking about Ray Dalio and a 3-minute interview that has just been released by the CNBC, in which he stressed out the fact that cash in this monetary environment is still trash, and in particular he analyzes all the main asset classes. In particular, he analyzes stocks and he analyzes bonds, and in particular treasury bonds. In particular, I want to show you this 3-minute video of Ray Dalio and my reaction to what he says, whether I agree or whether I disagree with his words. And in particular, the reason why I take a certain point of view in the matter. So let's go ahead, let's share the screen here, and let's first of all hear this 3-minute interview by Ray Dalio. Basically, the first thing that the journalist asks is whether or not the monetary policy that is in place will have a negative effect on the US economy and cause a recession. In particular, he asks whether or not the US economy, the Federal Reserve, will be able to slow down demand for products and services and therefore inflation, but keep the US economy strong. So let's go ahead and hear it.
Can the Fed effectively reduce demand without breaking the back of the economy?
Okay. And rather than just jumping to the answer, I always like to deal with the mechanics of
Right.
behind the answer, you know? And I think the answer is no, but here's the reason why. An interest rate, when there's a lot of debt.
So basically here Ray Dalio says that the Federal Reserve will not be able to decrease inflation without causing a recession. Let's go ahead and listen.
One man's debts are another man's financial assets. And they have to balance both of those things. And so they will not be able to raise interest rates to a high enough level to adequately provide a real return to investors. So if you think about the rock.
I remember everybody that the real return is the difference between the nominal return of a certain financial asset and the rate of inflation. So therefore we see that Ray Dalio says that it's not possible for the Federal Reserve to basically go back at a real positive rate of return for investors in the next 3 to 5 years.
Rising rates, and we say 3% is an interest rate,
Right.
or even 4% an interest rate. That is not going to be an amount of money that's adequate to compensate for the inflation rate. And we're in a paradigm shift, I think. A paradigm is, something happens for 10 years, an environment for 10 years, and at the end of that 10 years, people believe everything that happened in the prior 10 years, and then they get a surprise.
Right.
And then they start to change. And something like, for example, do I leave cash as a safe investment, or bonds are a safe investment after a 40-year bull market and those types of things? That begins to shift as they start to think, am I getting a real return? So there's going to be a supply-demand balance. Most importantly,
So basically here what Ray Dalio says is that there has been a massive bull run in the treasury market, which has driven down interest rates, and therefore we have lived in a situation that has gone ahead for 40 years, but that might change very quickly. And in particular, he means, of course, an increase in interest rates.
the Federal Reserve is going to sell, individuals are selling, foreigners are selling, and the US government is selling because it has to fund its deficit. So there's going to be a supply-demand problem that means that it produces a squeeze because so much money was put out at such cheap rates,
right,
and so much financing was taken that it'll be difficult to achieve that balance.
So I remember when you would tell us that cash is trash.
Yeah.
Is cash still trash?
Of course cash is still trash. Cash, I'm asking you, is your interest, you know how fast you're losing buying power in cash?
I okay. feel that in terms of inflation every day. However, I'm also, for those who own equities out there, they're feeling it even worse.
Well, it depends what cash is. Equities are trashier. Okay. The question is, what's going to get you a real return, right? And so we've shifted it into an environment where assets that do well, almost like in the 70s, are in those types of things. Real assets, real return assets in various ways are the best investments. I think the world is long. Here's a dynamic I think that's a problem. Everybody's long, equities and so on. And everybody wants everything to go up. And the Federal Reserve wants everything to go up. So what they do is they give you money and credit, lots of money and credit that helps hyping it. And when the more they hype it, the more it becomes somebody else's financial asset they're holding.
Yep.
And so the world is holding all these financial assets and so on. You can't have that. So you're going to have an environment, I think, of negative real returns. And so as you think about how do you diversify your portfolio or even be short those things, everything can't go up all right. the time. That system won't work that way.
Okay,
as an so asset that class, is the end the CDFI of, sector has the, now raised almost $1 billion in the public.
And in particular, now I want to go through it and understand why he's making certain statements. So basically, as we said, there has been a massive bull run of 40 years in the bond market, and we can say that also the equities have gone up over time at a very fast pace. Today, inflation is very high, and therefore for the real return on these assets is positive, okay? Is positive. Is not positive, is negative, okay? So the question here is, Ray Dalio says that basically since there is a lot of money supply in the market, both by the government, by the Federal Reserve, by US investors and by foreign investors, the bond market is bound to go down and start a massive bear market. Of course, we know that there is an inverse relationship between treasury bonds and interest rates, okay? So this means that according to Ray Dalio, there will be like in the 70s, due to the fact that inflation is very high, there will be a massive bear market in bonds. But my question now is, what if the Federal Reserve will not be able, as he says, to basically put the brakes on the economy without hurting it? Which means that it's going to basically slow down the economic growth and there is going to be a recession. Well, in recessionary periods, what happens is that the Federal Reserve goes back to the market, injecting a lot of liquidity in order to decrease interest rates and regain access to credit for investors and consumers. Okay? So in my opinion, what Ray Dalio says, it's a truth statement. But he basically underlines the fact that the US economy will do well also with high interest rates, and therefore the bond market is going to go down, and equities long term, and in particular we saw that he underlines things like materials, real assets, and so on, and in my opinion also banks and financial institutions are set very good in a certain market environment. But what he says is that basically We will have a bear market in bonds, that inflation is going to stay high for a prolonged period of time, and therefore our real returns will be negative. But what if the Federal Reserve is able to put to basically weaken inflation, but at the same time cause a recessionary environment? Well, in that case, this particular economic quadrant that he didn't talk about, well, we would have a situation in which the Federal Reserve needs to put some more money into the economy, therefore lowering interest rates and giving a lot of demand for money, which means that basically investors in that case would like to lock in the yield of 3% today, because it is supposed not to go high a lot, but instead to lower due to the fact that there will be again a lot of money in the economy that the Federal Reserve is going to put in order to make the US economy recover from a recessionary or a soft landing environment. So my opinion is that I totally agree with the fact that we are in a real returns, a negative real returns environment. What I don't agree of is the fact that we will have a massive bear market in bonds, particularly if the US economy will weaken in the next few months. Finally, I think that equities are going to recover. So even if this is a very particular, delicate, frail moment for equities, I think that long term, when interest rates are going to stabilize between 2% and 4%, and the US economy is going to basically remain strong despite slightly higher interest rate, we will have a lateral moment of bonds, the continuation of a bull market for equities, and of course also the value of the dollar is going to stabilize. Let's make sure that the dollar is in a massive bull market, and I think it will continue to stay in a massive bull market due to the fact that basically the Fed, the market is already discounting the possibility for the Fed to decrease inflation, and the fact that and the fact that the bonds are going to stay more or less at a 3%. And of course, the markets are also telling us, as far as the dollar is concerned, that the US economy is pretty strong despite the increase in interest rates of the Fed. So we are going to have a situation either where the Fed is able to basically slow down inflation without hurting the US economy. In that case, we would have that the dollar and the stock market go up while the bond market goes down, and therefore interest rates increase, and therefore there are more foreign investors that want to invest in dollar denominated asset. While on the other hand, if the attempt to slow down inflation brings the US economy to a recession, we are going to have a stronger bond market, we are going to have a weaker dollar, and we are going to have a very particular situation in equities. In particular, in a recessionary environment, this is counterintuitive, but we are going to see tech companies that are more that have a higher duration, which means that they are more sensitive to interest rates, rally more than for example financial institutions, that generally speaking they make money on the interest rate, the interest rate spread between what they lend from what they borrow from the Federal Reserve, what they lend to investors, and therefore we are going to see certain sectors of the stock market that recover faster, even faster during a recessionary environment. Because, for example, their cash flow is pretty stable, but the interest rates go down, and therefore the current value of the equity part of their balance sheet is increasing for the free cash flow model. So that was all about Ray Dalio's discussion of these 3 minutes in which he underlines the current political, economical and financial, of course, environment. If you like the video, please smash the thumbs up and comment down here. Moreover, we are going to talk a lot about finance, investing, money online, business models, and so on. So if you are interested in all these kind of topics, I really suggest you to subscribe here to the channel. I'm looking forward to come tomorrow with a new video. I thank you all for the attention. Have a great rest of your day.